BKFC 15 went out with a big bang, combat sports fans. The Hillbilly Hammer is back. Shaquille O'Neal makes a guest appearance, and we meet the first ever male ring boy. I've got the story next. Adam Pellerano and Rusty Crowder started the night's action. Both men were careful, taking their time and picking their shots. To start the third round, Crowder made a move on Pellerano that cost him, getting dropped as he attempted to turn up the offense. Pellerino boxed smart, however, and in the end got the win by decision. Congrats to Adam Pellerano. The second of the two preliminary fights were with the big boy heavyweight, Adrian Miles versus Lewis Rumsey. Rumsey was making his BKFC debut. Miles had previously fought at BKFC 9, where he lost to Wes Coombs. And boy, oh boy, this was a quick match, lasting just 20 seconds. Miles got caught by a left that may have injured his eye. So stepping in was referee Bill Clancy, stopping the match when Miles did not get up. Your winner, Lewis Rumsey, via TKO in the first round. Next up on the pay-per-view, the always colorful Quinton Henry squared off against Jason Fan. This was another BKFC blockbuster fight, with Henry dropping Fan in the first round. Henry will definitely be a fighter to watch in 2021. Quinton Henry via knockout in round number one. Next up, BKFC veteran Harris Stevenson returned to the squared circle, facing a much shorter Drew Lipton. Stevenson was listed as having an 8-inch height advantage here, but had the same reach. The action was fast and furious in the first round, with Stevenson knocking Lipton down twice. Your winner, Harris Stevenson via knockout in round number one. The next match brought out two fighting veterans, Brad Kelly and Kane Tomlinson Sr. Fans of BKFC may be familiar with Tomlinson, as he fought at Toe the Line 1 in September of this year. Kelly brought a wealth of MMA experience and was able to knock down Tomlinson three times in the very first round. The referee called a stop to the action, and bam, we had another fight in the books. Your winner, Brad Kelly, via TKO in round number one. Fight number four, Jenny Savage versus Sheena Starr. Both of the ladies fought their hearts out in a wild, wild brawl. Starr received a nasty injury to her eye early on, and despite her willingness to continue, the referee called it. Jenny Savage via TKO in round number two. Also during this fight, we got to see the long-awaited debut of the first ever BKFC ring boy, Clay Teal. Teal told me in my post-fight interview, the secret to his success was all in the hips. You go, Clay. The big guys were up next, with Josh Burns making his BKFC debut against Chris Sarro. Burns had two matches lined up before, both against Sam Shewmaker, before finalizing this fight with Sarro. These two fighters really got into it at the weigh-ins, and both were definitely on a mission fight night. In the second round, Burns landed a big right hand that sent Sarro to the mat. After he dropped him, Burns was still in Sarro's face before the referee intervened. Welcome to BKFC, Josh Burns, your winner via KO in round number two. Joining the broadcast team of Sean Willock and Chris Lytle before the Vogel versus Cochran fight, the one and only Shaquille O'Neal. O'Neal is a big fan of BKFC and talked about BareKnuckle being the future of combat sports. Shaq, you made a great addition to the broadcast team. Hope to see you back soon. Now onto the actual Tyler Vogel and Dakota Cochrane fight. And boy, was this a fight. Both men showcased their skills throughout the match. At the end of the third round, however, Vogel was caught with a nasty and powerful left hook by Cochrane. Cochrane continued to score in the fourth. Vogel started bleeding from his left eye. In the final round, Cochrane continued his assault, landing a big uppercut that split Vogel's eye wide open. A doctor checked the wound, called a stop to the action. Your winner, Dakota Cochrane via TKO in the fifth round. In the co-main event, England's Tyler Goodjohn made his BKFC debut. You may remember Goodjohn from BKFC 14 when he had words with Luis Baboon Palomino after Palomino fought Jim Allers. Goodjohn's opponent was the crafty Charles Bennett, no stranger to mixed martial arts as well as BKFC, having fought at both BKFC 2 and BKFC 9. Both men landed good punches, but Goodjohn scored more and got the win. Your winner, Tyler Goodjohn, via unanimous decision. After the fight, Goodjohn was interviewed. His next opponent of choice, Jason Knight. Now that's a fight that BareKnuckle News definitely wants to see. All that was left was the main event. Sam Shewmaker, the former BKFC heavyweight champion, squared off against Bobo O'Bannon. Fans may remember O'Bannon. He had an impressive win against Mike Kyle at Toe the Line 2. The Hillbilly Hammer had not fought since BKFC 4, where he was defeated by Chase Sherman, and in fact, hadn't fought professionally all year. However, if there was any ring rust at all, Shewmaker shook it off early as he landed punch after devastating punch to O'Bannon. Your winner, Sam Shewmaker, via TKO in the first round. As BKFC fight fans know, Shewmaker was scheduled to fight Mark Godbeer, with the winner facing Joey Beltran for the title. Godbeer got sick and had to drop out. Does that mean we could see a title match between Shewmaker versus Beltran in the new year? Looks like it could be happening in the spring. Next up, BKFC 16, with the long-awaited debut of Paige VanZant Super Bowl weekend. And we will be there in 2021 to bring you all the beautiful bloody action. I'm Susan Cingari for BareKnuckle News. And remember, no one beats us to the punch.